Welcome to Let's Play Daggerfall Unity, the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall Remastered in the Unity engine. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. This is a part zero video, just information about the series that I'm starting and the mods I've installed and all the settings and stuff like that. So there's no gameplay in this episode, and there's not going to even be character creation. That's going to be in the following episode. So if you're looking for that, skip this video. I know people give it thumbs down anyway because, I don't know, they're expecting something else. But yeah, there's a lot of information to give out here, so we're going to make it in a separate video so people can just skip it because they know about this stuff, but they don't care. So anyway, please no spoilers at all. I'll say this again, I'm playing it blind, which it's a blind run, meaning I've never played this before. Especially the main quest and monsters, different secrets and stuff like that, please leave that out. Let me either experience that or miss that on my own. I appreciate it very much. I read all the things, which means I basically read everything that's not, you know, I guess repetitive. So I'm gonna read stuff that's the same over and over. So the flavor text and stuff, I enjoy reading that, and text from NPCs and stuff like that. And I'm gonna run a separate series with me reading through the books. Not going to read them in this episode, but letters and stuff like that I'll read, of course. I play slowly and methodically, so keep that in mind. I have... Well, this is the Unity engine, which is a complete remaster, and I have a lot of mods installed, so... For the purists out there who say that, you know, it should be played as it originally was, I can definitely see that. I can respect that point of view. However, that's not what I'm doing for this Let's Play. I have how many mods installed? 40-something mods? I wrote them all down. I have 44 mods installed. That's counting all the collections of mods like the Dream and things like that, the remastered paintings, as one mod. So there's a lot installed here, and, you know, I'm gonna go over that after I go over the settings here. Right now, just so you know, I'm playing on the GTX, NVIDIA GTX 970. That's the one that says it has 4 gigs of RAM, but the 0.5 of the last... 0.5 of the last gig of RAM is like slow RAM. You might have heard about it. But yeah, in a few days I'm going to be getting an RTX 3060. So I'm going to be changing it up. The first few episodes are going to be with the 970 and then with the RTX 3060 after that. So it'll be interesting to compare. Because I do get some stutters now and then. And I'm playing on a brand new version, version 0.114, as you can see, just came out on June 6th, this year, 2021. As I'm playing this, it's June 7th, so it's brand new. Actually, did not plan that. I was like, oh wow, let's download Daggerfall Unity, and I see there's a version put up like a few hours ago. So hopefully there's no issues with mods, and if there are, hopefully they fix them. So who knows, we'll, we'll find out, right? And yeah, always show this window, this is handy. So anyway, I'm just going to go over the different settings here. It's a completely different experience, not only just having Daggerfall Unity, but with the Dream mod, basically makes it look like a modern... I wouldn't say like a AAA game, but maybe a AA indie game or something, possibly. There's a lot of improvements. So I'm going to go through this. All the settings I have here. VSync, yes, Swap health and fatigue. This is for people who are more familiar with the common, the modern Elder Scrolls, where the red bar is for health and green is stamina. But I played Arena a few months ago, so the first Elder Scrolls game, so I'm kind of used to having green for health and red for stamina, so I'm not going to swap that. Invert mouse, don't need that. Mouse smoothing, yes, really helps. Not a lefty, so I need that. Now, this is interesting, the player nudity, which I would normally turn off because I'm putting this up on YouTube, so... but what I've been seeing all over is that there are certain quests that are not available if you turn this off. So, I don't know why. So, I mean, it's probably a spoiler to tell me why, so please don't tell me why. I'll figure it out myself when some NPC requires me to be naked for something. I don't know. Enable for smooth fonts and high resolutions. Yes, because I am playing this in, 1080p. I'm going to play with a keyboard. So, going through all this stuff, starting dungeon like normal. Strength of screen recoil and player takes down. I don't know if I want that very high. Let's put it at medium. Some of this stuff I had, I changed for the Dream mod. Some of the stuff I don't know why they need it. I'm gonna get into it in a little bit. But the Dream mod recommends certain things. Dungeon textures I recommend for climate, mouse sensitivity, I put way down, 1.0 is too much. Open sensitivity, movement acceleration, they recommend that put that on. This has the classic, how we're familiar with holding the mouse down and then letting go of it to, fire a bow. Otherwise you just press and the bow is automatically, drawn and release. Toggle sneak. Yeah, I don't want to hold that down. So that alternate music. Now I'm going to change the music up now and then. There's different, there's like four or five different mods that change the music to orchestral, the old Yamaha, sound and everything like that. So I do want to hear that. So from now and then I'll change the music around. If I can, overwrite the Dream music, hopefully. Spell lighting, yes. Spell shadows. Yeah, all that cool stuff. Tooltips, a delay on it. I'm guessing, does it? Doesn't seem to change the delay here. I'm going to make it 0.2. Crosshair, yes. I might change the crosshair. Vitals indicators. Show indicators on vitals bars at display changes in vitals. I would think I want this on, but the dream mod recommended it off. I don't know why. And this displays a little arrow counter on, I think it's down here that shows you where how many arrows you have. Free scaling we have off because I don't want to stretch and, have it look all weird. Countdown, this is handy because normally it shows you how much time, the quest's been up there, but it's better to have it, counting down the remaining time. Inventory info panel, enhanced item lists. I think four items. If you turn this off, it displays just four items at a time. That's kind of crazy. So this is 16. Talk window modern style. Yeah, I have something else that changes that, I think the Dream mod might change that. Buff icons. Small. All this stuff is subject to change. Medium. I'm gonna keep it small. Show material for helms and shields, yes. Because so a lot of them look the same. You know, whether it's steel or iron, and you know, you can't use certain things. So you wanna know, hey, that's iron, I can't use iron. And they'll look the same. So it's a good thing to have that. Geographic backgrounds. Dream suggest, I kinda like this because it shows the background of, you know, where you are with your character. But I don't know, Dream says it should be off, so. This one, when you come out of a dungeon, it says, do you want to access your wagon? Rather than, you know, you could still access the wagon by going into inventory, I believe, but this prompts you. Outline regional map locations, Dream suggests that I have that off, I don't know. Enhancements, mod system, you have to have this on, and no mods will work without it. I think this is the same from loose files and stuff. Quest packs, whatever. Compress modded textures. I don't need this, I don't think. Seems to be working fine without compressing. Scale of the ambient light. This I have up. Would normally be like 0 point something, but I have it all the way up because I know YouTube has, you know, when you record things and then you upload it to YouTube, it's a little darker than it would normally, than what I see it as. So just so you guys can see better. And the torchlight, you know, I just put down a little bit because it's just a torch, right? And this, enabled. They give you torches when you start out, so this ties into that. Game console, in case you want console commands to like free yourself from places. I did this testing. I haven't actually played through the first dungeon. I teleported myself to the exit and left and walked to the next town just so I can test out these mods. So I've seen people play through the first dungeon, Privateer's Hold, I believe it's called, and but I haven't played it through myself, so that's that. So I've wandered around the first, the nearby town, which is Gothburg something or other. near-death warning, yeah, it begins to pulsate red, and just things, the screen starts to get darker when you're like near-death and stuff. Ultimate random enemy selection. I had this on, but the dream mod suggested recommended I have it off, so gives you, you know, random enemies in dungeons. I don't know. I might turn this back on at some point. Climb walls in all directions, jump off them and grab them. So you don't only have to go up and down, you can go side to side, jump off and grab other walls and stuff like that with this on. This, basically you make grunts and yelps and stuff like that. Players and NPCs go, eh, you know, when they're fighting. Enemy infighting, this is awesome. You can see enemies, different kinds of enemies, you know, undead fighting rats and whatever else. I saw a bat fight an imp when I was trying to leave the dungeon when I was teleporting out. It's pretty cool. Enhanced combat AI, yeah, basically gives you better AI than a normal Daggerfall. Allow magic item repairs. Now I have this off because from what I hear, if you allow your magic items to be repaired, it makes them really overpowered. So this makes them finite. They could disappear at a certain time. So it's like they have charges kind of thing. Instant repair services. Disables waiting for repairs. Otherwise, yeah, you guys saw me. If you watched the Elder Scrolls Arena that I did, you'd have to wait like 10 days for your staff or whatever weapon to be repaired, which would basically mean you'd go to an inn and just hang out for 10 days. So I'm kind of done with that, so I turned this on. So you go in, repair this, it's, you know, it's done, which is unrealistic, I know, but it's kind of, I don't know, I'm done with that. Guild quest, yeah, presents eligible guild quests in the list box. Handy. Equip bows in left hand. I turn it off because I'm not left-handed. My character's not left-handed. Maximum loiter time. Now, for some reason, Dream suggested we put this down to 6. I don't know why they would suggest that, what difference it makes. But basically, yeah, if you want to loiter, people would just, you can only sleep when you're walking around in town. You can't just sleep. You have to leave the town and camp or find an inn. And if you just want to wait around for like a store to open up or something like that, you can loiter, which basically means you're just hanging around. So if you don't have this up and you want to wait, say 12 hours, you're waiting, I think the default is 3 for Daggerfall. So you're waiting for 3 hours. 3 hours, 3 hours, 3 hours. It's easier just to have it as 12. So here, that's my resolution, full screen. Should the game keep running when it loses focus? Yeah, otherwise I'll just quit out. So, you can have this as fantastic, but the Dream mod recommended that we have it as beautiful. I think it looks it looks better in this setting than in fantastic. They recommended main filter, GUI filter, video filter all be trilinear, so that's what I did. Field of view, let me know what you guys, I know it makes some people nauseous if field of view is up too high. Dream recommended I put at 68, I believe, or the high 60s. So, I did that. I recommended terrain distance be 2. I had it all the way up, but they recommended it be at high. I might just play around with this stuff now and then, see if it looks any better. Maybe they recommend some of this stuff because they figure a lot of rigs won't be able to play with a very high shadow resolution or a higher terrain distance. I don't know. I don't know what the reasons are. So dungeon light shadows, interior light shadows, exterior light shadows, all the shadows on. This is just enabled. You can't turn this on or off. At least I can't. Retro rendering mode and rendering processing are off. That's basically to make it look like classic Daggerfall. And that's it for the settings. So now, the mods. So, a lot of this stuff, I don't know if it works. Some of the stuff we won't see till later, like airships. By Cadius is the version. You guys can see it, so I'm not gonna read the version. But, yeah, fly airships, you got a mod description. Settings. So, a small ship is 200,000, 300,000, 400,000. So this is how much it costs. This is with the preset of Dream. So, I don't know what the Dream changed, but I'm keeping it as is. If you put it at 0, then you can just... It doesn't cost anything, but I'm not going to cheat with it. But yeah, basically, it's an airship that will bring you to your, whatever destination you need, rather than running there or taking, riding a horse. How often they'll spawn. So you see, other ones, You see, supposedly other ones with other people on them. Instant summon ship. Yeah, have it fly to the player. I have this rope physics. Basically, yeah, the ropes move. And then this ship cargo. The amount of loot. Yeah, I guess you just pay more if you want more cargo. Dream enabled. Alright, so I'm just going to go over some of this stuff, basically. The Archaeologist Guild by Hazelnut. It's basically a whole new guild in Daggerfall where they're basically, it's if you don't use magic that often, I am making a mage character, but I want to see what the Archaeologist has as well. The only thing is that I plan on joining the Mages Guild as well. So when you, certain quests you do, I don't know if all of them for the Archaeologist, reduces your reputation or your standing with the Mages Guild from what I've heard a little bit. So most probably we can't do the top quests in either the Mages Guild or the Archaeologist Guild. So at one point I'm gonna have to choose, I'll do as many as I can, but then, I'm probably not gonna be able to do the top Mage Guild quest if I have the archaeologists, too much for the archaeologists, so I'm gonna see, how we're gonna do it. So what they have with this, it's a quest target locator device. So they require you find a certain thing, and it's basically a beacon that will show you, where to go to find this item, which is really neat. A language skill rework is basically, it makes the language skills actually useful, which is sweet. So, and then Basic Roads, also by Hazelnut. Basic Roads, Smooth Roads, Editing. I don't need to be editing, so that's all for that. So it just adds roads, coming out of towns and such, which is pretty cool. Better ambiance. Camera shaking, better footsteps, dungeon fog, and reverb. I think Dream already has footsteps, and maybe some of this other stuff, so I'm not sure how it's working with it, but it has a Dream setting, so which I've already applied. Basically, your armor volume clanking around, footstep volume. Oh, it has it at zero. Oh, it's not enabled. Look at that. Oh, we don't have any of this. Okay. They have most of this not enabled, I guess, because Dream handles this. The dungeon reverb is low. This footsteps and stuff are off. Camera shake amount is not adding anything, but it's multiplying here. Not completely sure about all this stuff. Dungeon fog is turned off. Dungeon lighting. Better rain. Enable better rain and better snow. So those are on. Make snow particles and rain particles look a little better. But I guess Dream handles the other stuff, so. Birds in Daggerfall, pretty sweet. Flying birds. Basically, you can have maximum amount of birds spawn, minimum spawn time, maximum spawn time. Pre-warmed, which is when you first enter an outside location. Yeah, when you walk outside, how many are spawned? Zero. So I guess it takes a little bit spawn time. 30 seconds, I guess. I'm not sure if that's minutes. That's probably seconds. All right, so we got crows, hawks, and geese. So, chance for crows, minimum crows, maximum crows, 1 to 10 crows, hawks, 1 or 2 hawks. I changed this to 2, it was 1. But I figure sometimes a hawk might have a mate. I know they're solitary birds, but geese chance. Geese are in a flock, so 1 to 10 geese. I figured it'd be even more, like 20, 30 geese sometimes. I see a lot of them in the sky sometimes myself. In real life, talking about. Convenient clock. Now, this shows you the time, week, day, and the day. Basically, it'll say mid-ass. Whatever time, mid-ass, and then the day. Or, basically in Tamriel form. And this has a preset for Dream as well, so which I've applied. And you can change the border color, all this stuff, 12-hour clock. Some of the settings I hear don't work with Dream, so it's good to have that preset there. Convenient quest log, which is basically, yeah, you. The default is everything's laid out in like a big paragraph, but the way this works, it has basically, I think, from what I can see, one line, and you click on it, and it shows you the rest of the information, just like, you would expect in nowadays RPGs. Sky shards are, yeah, sky shards scattered around the world. I haven't found any yet. Every time you find a third sky shard, you can add a point to an ability, whatever, strength, intelligence, personality, wherever you want to put it. So it's just a neat thing to add in. And 1 point for every three of them, it's a pretty big area for Daggerfall, so I can't imagine finding all of them. You'd have to walk all over. A lot of them are put in areas of nearby areas of importance, but some are just in the middle of nowhere. When I hear Decorator, yeah, I'm not naming all the people. Thank you to Uncanny Valley, Macadenu. There's a lot of the same people doing multiple ones. Joshua Steinhauer, Hazelnut, Cadius. I'm trying to remember to say the names of the people who've put this up. Decorator is basically for your house. In your player home, ship, or airship, you can add different things. Place them how you like them, basically how you think of player homes for Elder Scrolls games. I'm not sure, if it works exactly the same, probably not. Place, so it costs 100 gold to place an object, so I'm guessing that the rationale behind this is you're not placing it, but you're hiring somebody to place it. Just like in Skyrim, for example, you want this in your house and you have to pay for this. And then you go in your house and ta-da, there it's there. But guild restriction. Restrict placing spell makers, potion makers, and item makers unless you have guild access. That's fair, because otherwise you can just circumvent that because you need guild access by default or temple access to be able to use these things. Hotkey is a slash, so have to get that in mind. It's going to be a while before I have a player home. Distant terrain, basically, yeah, adds distant terrain, increases view distance. You can see for miles and miles and miles. So, terrain transition, fade into skybox. I'm not sure all this stuff. Sea reflections we have off because I think that conflicts with dream for some reason. Improved terrain. Locations. So this is the dream stuff. All in-game cinematics have been AI upscaled to recreate an original sound was cleaned. So this is done. The dream is done by a multitude of people. The head honcho of all this is KOW, King of Worms, and he's done a lot of the work himself and oversee the project and this and that. So, but yeah, Distant Terrain is by Nistel. Thank you, Nistel, and this is by Cadius, which I believe I said. So, yeah, this makes the cinematics much better. 528 AI upscaled and handcrafted citizen sprites with new close-up frame faces redrawn by Adranus. Initial shaders pass now includes the guard for better VIO compatibility. What is VIO? That is Villager Immersion Overhaul. So it works with that. It's another mod. Yeah, King of Worms, Adranus, Handheld, Megaten here. 4,500 files of the first person handheld weapons items and animation. I can't believe the amount of work that's gone into these. These are all high quality textures and items. All HUD elements. This is what? HUD and menu. Cursor, crosshairs, buttons, tabs, map, and inventory systems, game screens, time, weather, aware, character backgrounds, and much more. By King of Worms and Arl. And then mobs. 4,300 frames of the in-game mobs have been AI upscaled by Mazen Face and his AI team and further manually processed by King of Worms. Added emission maps for glowing eyes of selected mobs. All the corpses have been adjusted by King of Worms to better match the size and colors of the mobs. Music, they've even redone the music. Official Dream music produced by Byte Mixer. 81 tracks with the original 1996 tonality with new high quality MIDI instruments and mastering. Now the music is awesome, but from now on in, as we get further into the series, I'm going to change it up. I know there's an orchestral edition of the musics I want to try out, so I'm not sure. I might have to disable this just to get that working. We'll figure it out. NPCs. This is by King of Worms. 712 static NPC frames have been redrawn. Adrian has made a final touch on shading, faces, hands, and details. If an NPC is animated, the frame count has been increased for more plausible results. The paper doll. This is the way your character looks. Enhanced paper doll. Observatory system. 16,000 files. I can't imagine the amount of work they did into this. King of Worms, Citrus, and Adranus. Portraits. These are NPC portraits. 576 NPC conversation portraits. So there's a little, face that shows up when you're talking to somebody. Upscaled, manual click, corrected and redrawn, adjusted with the shaders. Amazing. Sound. Based on clean sound clips. That's another mod by Pango and Tamriel. Mixed down by Heligad. A lot of the 323 used sounds afterwards. Slight echo to the sounds of players only in dungeons. Added new sounds through hacks. Variations to sounds which are duplicates. Created new sounds to replace those which are really bad. Tweaked the volumes. All the signature sounds are still present as always with the Dream Project. This is a vanilla friendly experience. So there's no settings for any of these things. They're just description. Sprites. 1200 in-game sprites. Nature flats, 50% of them by J-Man of War, animals, magic effects, dungeon props, inventory items, ingredients, loot piles, artifacts by Adranus, and so much more. Crazy. And then finally, textures. Almost 500, 5,000 files, HD textures based on the original art. Everything is made in a way is inspired by the original. Every texture is fine-tuned, physically based, material properties, emission maps, normal maps. Height maps, occlusion, smoothness, roughness, shaders, and more insane. And then these are hand repainted paintings, I think. High resolution paintings. Yeah, replaces the nature painting textures in the game with high resolution versions. 85 of 142 images included, so not all of them. This, unfortunately, there is an not safe for work version. Which I regret. I cannot, really play it because then I'd have to block it out from YouTube. So this takes the nude, I mean, pixelized nude paintings and makes them, nudity removed. Sometimes they're new paintings. They're just new, completely different artwork. So instead of having some naked girl reclining, you'll have. I mean, they still look cool because they're, it'll be like a sword maiden kind of image instead. And then painted replaces the painted painting textures with high resolution. Nudity been removed. Sorry, guys. So enhanced sky. Yeah, the cloud quality is up to 2048. That's insane. That's the only thing you could change. And then sun flare, recommend off. I don't know, because it might be a little overbearing. I don't know, maybe. And then hand-painted models. Kind of weird that I have that looked up. I'll go back to that. Hand-painted models for buildings. This goes well with Dream. Really, like, there's no description for this one really, but buildings, main, and treasure piles, just, hand-painted, high-resolution models. The hotkeys for weapons, spells, and potions, pretty sweet. You can turn it off. So you have 1 through 9 for your hotkeys, and then 0 turns the little display off in the bottom. You'll see it in the Let's Play, the series I do. Hand-painted models for Oh yeah, just went over this. Improved interior lighting. Improves interior lighting. So, yeah, this is the presets for Dream as always. It's enabled. NPCs have shadows. These are the lights. I guess it looks better than here. Intensity. You can change all this stuff if you want to. Enemy shadows. Yeah, this was a good thing to have this off because ghosts and wraiths should not cast shadows, so this is off for them. Dungeon lights color, flickering lights. Hopefully this won't be too crazy flickering because you can change the flicker's strength, so I'll turn this down if it's like really distracting or annoying or something. Fireplace settings, yeah, light from fireplaces. Basically all these light sources, player torches, all that. Awesome stuff. And villager immersion overhaul, this works with dream. Quick fix for city stutter, yeah. But otherwise, yeah. There's less people out when it's raining, snowing, or storming. There's different population counts for cities, hamlets, villages, and farms, as you can see. Dynamic sprites they recommend have off because I guess it doesn't work well with Dream. Says villager spawn types. Classic spawn is off. Prostitutes are back on. I believe cut from the game originally. Guards attack foes, villagers run away. They also run away when you attack other villagers, but that might be default. And then corpses. Yeah. I messed around with that. Killing people and then going to jail, being caught. Loading screen is pretty sweet. It makes basically loading screen, which looks pretty sweet. You have presets. I used the Dream, but you can have Skyrim style. Skyrim with sprites, Dishonored Oblivion. But I'm not changing that. I don't know what the GUI depth is. Graphical user interface depth. I don't know what that means. So anyway, dungeons have it all. I have it on, so when you go. Yeah, when you go into and out of a dungeon, get a loading screen. But a building, every time you go in and out of a building, I feel is a bit overkill, so I turn that off. And then show for minimum 3 seconds goes by pretty quick. I think it's over in less than, it seems like less than 3 minutes. You basically barely have enough time to read aloud the little tool tip, which says over here. Basically shows little tips like you see in Skyrim and I believe Oblivion as well. Shows you little tips about the world and the gameplay and this and that. We don't have press any key. Otherwise it would wait until you press a key. Death screen. After the video, it'll show the death screen, which I took out the text because Dream adds its own little message for the death screen. So yeah, show death screen. Don't disable the video. I eventually might disable the video just because how many times are you gonna see that same screen with the crow cawing and the people loading you into a crypt kind of thing. Loading label. Yeah, this is basically all this. You can change the fonts, font size, font color. So this is my loading please wait. This is my nod to EverQuest. I don't know what dynamic. I don't know what checking this really does. I'm not sure when the end text happens. And this is when you die. I took this out because, like I said, Dream has their own little message for when you die after the video plays. So yeah, tips. And then there's a second thing. You can change the font, file position, all this stuff of the tips. I did make it a lot bigger. Like I made the font size a lot bigger, so it's easier for you guys and myself to see. Because otherwise, it's really small on the screen. I think it would just take up like this part of the screen. So I made it a little bigger. And then quests shows messages, which is like I don't know. I did see that. I'm like, that's stupid to have, but some people might like it. That's turned off, so none of this stuff applies. Level progress, it'll show your level. Level and then whatever number the level is, it shows up here on the top right. So that's pretty sweet to have as well. And you can change all the font stuff. Enemy preview, I feel, shows a random enemy graphic. I turned that off because I feel it might be kind of spoilery. I'm sure there's gonna be some new enemies that I haven't found, I haven't seen in Arena, so I kind of want to experience that, you know, run into those in the wild without having to say, oh, this is what this enemy looks like. A random 3D model. Yeah, that's enabled. So it'll show, like, you know, a cart or wagon or different things. I don't even know what filmic tone mapping is, but the Dream recommended it be on. So. And then NPC health indicators. Basically, what I did with this is shows health bar. Right. Only shows the health indicator if the NPC is taking damage. Otherwise, everyone walks around with 100 out of 100 over their head. And it's a little distracting. So when someone gets hurt, even just 1 point off or whatever, it starts to show, you know, 99 out of 100, whether they get hurt by you or an enemy, something like that. And what's funny is that we friendly NPCs is supposed to be green, pacified, yellow, but I've seen everyone with just red. So I don't know what that is. And that's, this is how close you have to be. I don't know if that's 10 feet or whatever to see from far away. You can't see the how many hit points they have, which makes sense. That's a preset. There are no presets. Yeah, this is turning out to be a long video. Persistent dungeons. Basically, when you leave a dungeon and go back in normal Daggerfall, vanilla experience, all the enemies would reset. So everything would be back to the way it was, or, you know, randomized or whatever. But this, if you kill everything in a dungeon and you go back in, everything's still dead. So you can change how many days to remember, you know, otherwise things respawn. Corpses stay. I have it as forever. Maximum number, unlimited. And this ignores the main quest dungeons, which is good because sometimes you might want to find a certain enemy that has something on it, and I don't know. I hear it's good to have this unchecked because you could mess up the main quest maybe by having this on. So, and this stores dungeon data to temporary files. Otherwise, it doesn't remember all this stuff for as long, for infinity, after all. So. Ready spellcasting hands is the last thing I put on. I'm not even sure. It looks pretty sweet. I don't think it's animated at all. But if you have a certain spell, you know, readied, like Fireball, your hands will glow red. Basically just shows your hands as, you know, on the lower part of the screen, as a lot of games would show, you know, so. Displays hands when ready for spellcasting. That's all that does. By Jeff Etienne, Lipold of Persistent Dungeons, thank you, Zorbarax, The Lakus, Kamer, Division, Villager, Immersion Overhaul, Shortbeard did improve interior lighting, Alexander Sig did all these hand-painted models, Macadenu again for the hot key bar, Enhanced Sky by Lipold, Fosley did all these hand high-res paintings, because I'm forgetting to say, everybody. So, post-processing by the Lakus. Initially, yeah, post-processing effects. And we have a preset for Dream. I selected Dream with Reshade, because I have the Reshade in working. So, they recommend not have anti-aliasing. But we do have ambient occlusion. We have motion blur. We have vignette. Darkenings towards the edge of the screen. This it creates reflections. This is very expensive. I mean, I try to run with it on, but they recommend, Dream recommends I have it off. So, no bloom. Bloom can be annoying. Dithering, yes. Eye adaptation is off. Depth of field is off. We have another screen. There's more depth of field stuff. But yeah, this can add a lot of between this and Dream, and I guess some of the other texture mods, can add a lot. You need a lot of RAM, not just VRAM, but actual RAM. I found that in my testing, what I'm running here, I have 16 gigs of DDR4 RAM in my setup, on my computer, so it uses about 7.5 to maybe just shy of 8 gigs of that. So when I start this up, I have to close Firefox, close off Steam and everything like that. Otherwise, I start to run low on memory, believe it or not. Roleplay Realism. Modular Roleplay and Realism Gameplay Modifications by Hazelnut. All this stuff is on. If you click a bed, you can sleep in an inn, or I guess in your player home. How you draw your bow, if you wait longer, you do more damage. I guess you two hit as well, you more chance to hit. Encumbrance effects. Actually gonna turn that off. Bandaging. I know, I can see having it on. I see the point for having it on, but I really don't want to deal with it. It makes your speed go down, basically, the more encumbered you are. I might turn it on at some point, but prefer not to have it on. Bandaging, you can, based on your medical skill, you can only board your ship in a port town. Makes sense. Underworld expulsion. Enables underworld guilds to expel members for poor performance with prejudice. So that would make the game harder. So I'm going to turn that off, at least for now. Mind you, this is the first time I'm playing Daggerfall. So I'm a first-time player. If you're more experienced, you might want to turn some of these things on. Prevents climbing with a weapon drawn. That's fine. I'll sheathe my weapon to do that. Weapon speed. Moderates DPS of weapons for characters with high-speed attributes. I'm not giving anything high. I have high speed, so whatever, but makes sense. Moderates the two-hit bonuses of weapon materials. So skill remains key factor. Makes sense. Increases equipment damage proportional to max condition. Okay. Enemy appearance. Yeah, based on class, on their class. Changes purification potion to cure poison rather than grant invisibility. Looks like that's a bug in the original Daggerfall, so yeah. Purification should cure poison, not make you invisible. So, it's a good thing. Automatically extinguish any light sources when you exit a dungeon. Use classic displayed strength damage bonus instead of classic internal value, it's fine. And variant NPCs and shops and taverns, yeah. Sets the maximum amount per level and be borrowed from banks. 10,000 per level. That's pretty generous. Enhanced writing. Yeah. Improved presentation allows galloping. Realistic movement. Horse and cart movement. Backwards and sideways more realistic and limited. Yeah. Follow terrain. Enables terrain following when riding. And then Dream is a preset, yeah. So I use the Dream preset here. They recommend it have to 32 for the gradient. And then refine training. Refines guild training services, so skill is selected first. Enable refine skill training. Variable training price based on skill level as well as player level. And intensive training we have off. As the Dream recommends it off. For a session per day for 5 days for extra cost. A session per day. I guess without this on, you can't have a session, multiple sessions, you know, day after day kind of thing. That's fine. Real grass. Ground cover with grass, flowers, water, plants. Makes it look really pretty. You can change all these things. There's a Dream setting, which I used, so they recommend all this stuff, the height, the width of the grass, all this stuff. spring, summer, fall, how the grass looks. Pretty sweet. They really do a great job with all this stuff. More detailed textures. Swamp vegetation and little plants near water ponds. So that's on. Noise spread is, yeah, more varied the vegetation will look. Density, minimum, maximum. Flowers, stones, flying insects, even particle system bugs. Really looking forward to seeing all this stuff. Details are drawn up to this distance. And no override, and then there's more. Detail, density, no texture override. So this is by Uncanny Valley and the Lakers. Hazelnut did roleplay and realism, post-processing. What is all that stuff? Okay. So Taverns Redone adds more detail and visual variation to taverns. So there's no... That's by Uncanny. Is it Uncanny Valley or just Uncanny? And then there's a dream patch. Yeah, wood textures look like dirt. So it's good to have that on as well. I don't want wood looking like dirt. Tedious Travel, which is not a good name for this. It basically makes you travel, but you can increase the speed. Not the speed at which you travel, but the speed at which the game runs as you're traveling. So it's basically like fast-forwarding the game. So it's pretty sweet. You can also have... be interrupted. You can change it at any time if you want to look around. So, the area. So, it's just a good way. Say the sites get eaten by a Gru. That's a Zork residence. Made slightly more bearable by time compression. Yeah, so you can... I don't say it's slightly more bearable. It's a lot more bearable from what I've seen. So, you can increase at least up to 32% of your original. I think it's even higher than that. So, it's basically like fast-forwarding through. But then you can get interrupted by monsters. Or if you see something, maybe you can stop in time. You can press interrupt button on the top to stop. You can change how fast the game is fast forwarding while you're traveling, kind of thing. And there's different settings. There's not much for... So avoid random encounters. So I might have turned this off. Yeah, it's not even a dream setting. I think I turned this off. I might turn this on as I get, you know, more familiar with the game and a little higher level, stuff like that. So this avoids it completely. Oh, it doesn't... looks like it doesn't avoid it necessarily, but then makes you have a chance to avoid an encounter, which I set to 80. Which I'm guessing is 80%. Based on the higher, whichever is higher, running or stealth. So, that's sweet. That's by Jedidia. And then, we're almost done with the mods, but there's some that don't show up here. Trees of Daggerfall by VM Blast. It's only Temperate Zone. The winter trees are not yet completed. So this one says, for better performance, use terrain distance 1 or 2. In the settings, as I showed you earlier, I have it set to 2. So yeah, there's no settings for that. World Tooltips by Jeffe Tien. Displays info about NPCs, buildings, items, and other interactables. Hide default interactable tip, default navigation that have been intended to be secret, right? So this avoids it from basically giving you a spoiler that, hey, you know, otherwise if you find a secret door, you'll get a little tool tip showing up when you go over the secret door saying interact. So it kind of gives away the fact that there's a secret door there because, oh, that just looks like part of the wall and it says interact. So I turn that off, so... gives an unfair advantage, I feel. And then Vibrant Wind works well with the real grass. Changes strength of wind according to current weather. Now the settings has Dream, I think recommended 0, no more than 0.4. I believe that's with Trees of Daggerfall as well. If you have it over 0.4, the trees blow, I mean the leaves on the trees like spaz out. They vibrate so fast. So you don't want it more than 0.4. So that's what I've done there. And that's it for the stuff we have here. And then there's a few more mods. I know I've been talking forever. This is why I have it as one separate video. So, the other settings and things I have do have. What is it? See if there's any other notes I have here. Because I have. In the ini file, I have small dungeons equal true. Smaller dungeons equal true. That's an ini file. It's an experimental thing. Basically takes all the dungeons, like not the main quest dungeons, but the random dungeons, and makes them smaller, basically around the size of the first dungeon. So otherwise you have giant dungeons for everything. So smaller dungeons equals true is a good thing to have on. So that's an ini file. So the non-listed mods, because these show up in quest packs and other places, so they don't show up in the mod list here, is Daggerfall Unity Quest Pack 1. I'm using version 2021.06.02. That's by JH or J underscore H or JH2971 is the name on the Nexus. Basically adds a lot more quests, more interesting quests, guild quests and such like that. No Rush Main Quest version 1.08. Basically change the text files. That's also by JH or JH2971. It basically takes all the time limits out of the main quest. So because for the purpose of this series, I like to play a little bit of the main quest, do some other stuff, go back to the main quest, do some other stuff, so it won't be good to like run out of time and then just fail completely. So, No Rush Main Quest is a good thing to have on. And then there's a Forgotten Quest Pack. There's no version for that. That's also by JH or JH2971. Those are a bunch, like, this. I think there's only four of them. I'm not completely sure. But a few quests that were. I'm not completely sure about it, but they're either quests that were present in the actual Daggerfall and were restored content, or they were quests made by someone for the original Daggerfall, not Unity, from way back when, before Unity even existed, and JH took these quests and made them compatible with Unity. So that's not on the Nexus because he hasn't had permission by the person who made these or persons who made these quests yet. But you can find it. And yeah, again, I forgot to say, but in the description of the video, besides having timestamps to go to different things, I list all the quests that I have installed with the links, download links. And I'm gonna have them listed in the playlist as well. Depending, hopefully I have enough space. But as what I plan on doing with the playlist, as I add mods, I'll add it to the playlist description. You know, episode 20, whatever, this mod, you know, was added, kind of thing. And what else? Yeah, there's a bunch of things, a bunch of quests that were added, some of them fairly recently, by someone called I'm So Bad at Nicknames. You can find them on the Nexus, of course, download descriptions. Just gotta find them all. So he's put a bunch in. Where are they? Yeah. I Gaksha the Orc Companion version 1.2 that adds basically a request to avenge somebody's death who means something to this orc. And then if you complete the quest, she shows up from time to time, talks to you, and then goes away. She might appear in dungeons to help you battle, and then she goes away. Basically comes and goes kind of thing, just, you know, I guess when you least expect it kind of thing. So that seems pretty neat. Mercenaries version 2.4, you can hire mercenaries to help you in your battles. Pretty sweet. These are all by, I'm so bad at nicknames. The username. Tavern Games version 1.2, you can play different games in taverns, like mini games and stuff like that. Sounds sweet. There's another one that says called Perform at Taverns. I decided not to install that because some people are having problems with it. And even after they basically deactivated and completely took the mod out, that it was still like in their save games of giving them error messages and this and that. So I decided not to, you know, have that installed. There are a bunch of mods that I decided not to install based on either they make the game more difficult, which for more advanced players, which I am not, or they're like had conflicts with other mods, or there were other mods that basically did the same thing that they do better. Basically, like pick one terrain mod, so I picked distant terrain kind of thing. What else? Iliac Bay Battlefields version 1.02. Basically, you can come across armies battling as you're walking around the countryside kind of thing. Populated Buildings version 1.2. I have that put on, but not. I have it like non-tavern edition, so you'll find more and varied NPCs in different buildings, but not in taverns because, from what I hear, there's some conflict because the game thinks that they're enemies, so you have trouble going to sleep with them in the building, so you have to wait around for them to like leave because the game thinks they're enemies and you can't sleep when enemies are nearby kind of thing. And is that it for him? No, there's more. Actually, I can't see what I wrote. Town Description in Details, version 1.1. Basically adds, I think, arena-style descriptions to towns and things like that. The Conjurer's Artifacts, volume 1. Basically, you find different artifacts which act like wands, which basically you can summon creatures with them, and they have a certain amount of charges to them or something, and random. There's different ones, and there's like random effects, random enemies that they'll, you know, how many enemies, how many monsters are conjured, and what type, basically. Banditry and Traveling Merchants, version 1.1.1. Basically, you can encounter traveling merchants of various types. You can rob them if you want, or you can trade with them. Pilgrimages version 1.2.2. You can take pilgrimages to various temples in the wilderness, and there may be NPCs who've taken pilgrimages there, and you can trade with them, talk with them, that kind of thing. Get quests from them. You can there's random effects from like whatever deity you're taking a pilgrimage for. I think they can give you a buff, they might give you a quest, or nothing might happen. It's random. And then, what else? I think we're almost done. Fancy Vitals Indicators. There's no version to that by VM Blast. Basically has improved interesting textures, like patterns to your strength, not strength, but your hit points, stamina, health, stamina, and magicka bars. So I've installed that. And Readable Books, no version, by Willersha. Willershuah. It basically takes the books and fixes the formatting error, stops it from going, like, off the screen kind of thing, which I hear can happen. Makes it easier to read. I would love for there to be a mod where you can actually have the books appear, like, as a book you would think of, like, as in Morrowind, Oblivion, Skyrim, which is actually a book where you turn pages and stuff like that. I don't need a fancy animation, but it's basically the way the books look in Daggerfall and Daggerfall Unity is basically like a scroll that you just, you know, you scroll down. So it would be cool if there was a mod out there. Hope somebody's listening out there who makes mods. Basically make it look like a book where you can turn pages and the text is on the book kind of thing. But that's it. Wow, I can't believe I've been talking for so long. Those are all the mods and things that I have installed. So next episode, gonna actually be rolling up a character, and it shouldn't take an hour. I am gonna make a custom class and do it that way, but it's basically gonna be like a mage, basically like a modified mage kind of thing. And yeah, I look forward to actually playing this. Let's talking about all these settings and mods. If you guys have any other mods you might suggest, let me know. I think I've been through all of them. I've looked through all the ones on the Nexus and on the Daggerfall Unity forums. There might be some others out there which, you know, are on neither, maybe? But yeah, I'm willing to take any suggestions for new mods to install, different settings to try, and, you know, any other kind of anything like that. Let me know what you think. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the actual character creation video. Always, seek adventure.